Hello viewers, you are most welcome back to the channel, and over the past few weeks I've made a series of videos on how to apply effectively to both the University of Ghana and the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology. So please do want to watch those videos to keep you well informed, and if you have any inquiries you want to address, please make sure to ask them and also subscribe to the channel and don't miss out on my future videos. So today we are going to look at the University of Kekus, also known as the University of Choice, and the main aim of this video is to educate prospective applicants with regards to the University of Cape Coast admission process and the available programs which is being offered, as well as its entry requirements. This video is also to help prospective applicants avoid common mistakes when applying, such as wrong entry of their bio data and their examination details when applying to the University of Cape Coast. There is also the case where prospective applicants apply with very high ambitions. An instance where somebody with aggregate 20 applies for programs like medicine, pharmacy, and nursing, and also choosing competitive programs in all three choices. So someone with aggregate 25 decides to select Bachelor of Science, Actuarial Science as his or her first choice, and the second choice he or she decides to select Bachelor of Commerce Accounting, and the third choice he or she decides to select Bachelor of Education Management. So with an aggregate of 25, you should desist from selecting such competitive programs. Applicants should also try to desist involving third party individuals such as school teachers, middlemen, cafe attendants, and university staffs who promise to assist you to gain admission at a fee or cost whatsoever. Projected applications is set to double this year to the University of Cape Coast due to the free SHS initiative by the government. So due to the large intake in our universities this year, applications to the University of Cape Coast must be done with extra care. Moving on to the minimum entry requirements to the University of Cape Coast. Applicants must have credit passes, grade C6, in 6 subjects, including English language, mathematics, integrated science, or social studies, and any 3 relevant elective subjects to read any bachelor's degree program. So credit passes, meaning you need grades A1 to C6 in all the core subjects, as well as any 3 relevant elective subjects. For the degree program, your overall aggregate should not be more than 36 for WASSCE and 24 for SSCE. However, fee-paying facilities are available for applicants who are unable to meet the competitive cutoff point, although such candidates must meet the minimum entry requirements. So what this means is, if you don't meet the cutoff for a competitive program, assuming Bachelor of Nursing last academic year, the cutoff was aggregate 11 and you had an aggregate of 12 or 13, what you can do is to apply for fee paying. What it says is that you must also meet the minimum entry requirement of at least credit passes in all your core subjects and any 3 relevant elective subjects to be able to qualify you for the fee paying. So if you have a D7 in your core subject, you cannot apply for fee paying. So we are going to look at how the University of Cape Coast interprets its WAEC results for both WASSCE and SSCE. So for WASSCE, A1 to C6 means the value of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and should not exceed an aggregate of 36 if you want to apply for any bachelor's degree program. And that of SSCE, the value of A to D means 1, 2, 3, and 4, and should not exceed an aggregate of 24 if you also want to apply for any bachelor's degree program at the University of Cape Coast. So we are going to look at some of the application process. Applications are invited from suitable qualified persons for admission into undergraduate programs of the University of Cape Coast for the 2020-2021 academic year. Persons who will be writing WASSCE this year awaiting 2020 WASSCE results can also apply. So if you know you are writing WASSCE this year, you can also apply to the University of Cape Coast as an awaiting student. Applicants should visit www.ucc.edu.gh, then go to admissions and click on apply now for further instructions. Alternatively, applicants should visit www.uccghanaportal.com and proceed with the application. There are two alternative websites you can visit for the admission process. Applicants are required to provide the following information at the back of the large EMS envelope: application reference number, full name, postal address, first choice program, application category, whether undergraduate, postgraduate, diploma to degree, distance. Application category, which should be one of the following: either SSCE or WASSCE, or post diploma, or a post first degree, or other, to be specified by the applicant. Applicants are advised to read application instructions as well as the contents of the admission brochure very carefully before completing the online application form. So when you purchase the e-voucher to the University of Cape Coast, you'll be given a brochure, and this brochure contains the entry requirements for all the programs that are being offered at the University of Cape Coast, as well as their current cutoff points. So these cutoff points should serve as a guide when you are applying for any program in the University of Cape Coast. Applications on which application reference numbers are not indicated will not be processed for admission. So always make sure to indicate your reference number when you are applying online, and also when you are submitting your hard copies to the University of Cape Coast at the back of the EMS envelope. Practical examinations for Bachelor of Education, Physical Education. Candidates applying for Bachelor of Education, Physical Education should note that the date for the practical examinations will be communicated to them later. Submission of copies of completed application forms. Two copies of the completed online application forms accompanied by two copies of your resource slip should be sent by post and not delivered by hand. So when you are done with your online application, always make sure to make photocopies of your proof of registration and two copies of your resource slip, and this should be delivered by post only. Copies of the completed online application form should be addressed to the Directorate of Academic Affairs, DAA. No additional documents will be accepted after submission of completed application forms. So please make sure all your documents are ready before finally submitting to the University of Cape Coast, because they do not take any additional documents for processing your application. Applicants are to note that only photocopies of certificates or resource slips should accompany completed application forms and is not returnable. So prospective applicants should note that they should not add their original copies of their documents when applying, because when you use your original copies, you cannot get them back. So try and make photocopies, and these copies are the copies that has to be submitted to the University of Cape Coast. A change of program after the submission of application forms will also not be allowed. So the University of Cape Coast, unlike the University of Ghana and the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology, does not allow change of program when you apply online or also submit your hard copies to them. So extra care must be taken when selecting the programs. Always use last year's cutoff points to serve as a guide when you are selecting. And always make sure that the selection of your program choices should be in order of preference, which is from the very competitive programs to the least competitive programs, based on your final aggregate. So if you know you have an aggregate of, let's say, aggregate 19, and there are programs which cut off at aggregate 16, you don't select those programs. You select programs which are from 19 and above. Examination settings and results. The University of Cape Coast accepts a total of 3 examination settings. Persons awaiting 2020 WASSCE results must select the awaiting results option before providing their examination details. Those who already have results should not select the awaiting results option, but rather go ahead to verify their results. So when you key in your index number, the month, and the year on the online application portal, you should be able to see your WAEC results. And please cross-check to make sure that these results are the correct verification that is displaying at the online application portal. Awaiting candidates can indicate their past WASSCE results if they have. So if you know you are an awaiting candidate and you wrote WASSCE in the past, you can also indicate those past results, including your awaiting details. The University of Cape Coast accepts all past WASSCE and SSCE results. The University of Cape Coast also accepts a combination of May, June or NOVDEC results. The University of Cape Coast also accepts a combination of WASSCE and SSCE results. So if you know you wrote WASSCE back in 2018 and you wrote SSCE back in 2006 and you want to apply to the University of Cape Coast, you can use both results to apply, that is the WASSCE and the SSCE. Application errors. Applying with the wrong information details such as your name, your contact information, your address, your passport picture, and your email address. Providing the wrong WAEC index number can also affect your application to the University of Cape Coast. And some of these common errors applicants make is to mix up the digit numbers, the year, and the month of exam sitting. So please take note of this. Make sure your correct index number is well indicated, the month, the year on the online application portal. Incomplete application online will also affect your admission to the University of Cape Coast. So please make sure to complete all the online application categories and print out your final proof of application as a form of evidence that you have applied to the University of Cape Coast. Also do well to keep your login details, which entails your serial number and the PIN, at a safe place, or even take a picture on your phone or store the details on your phone so you'll be able to download your admission letter when you gain admission to the University of Cape Coast, because this is the same login details that you are going to use to download your admission letter if you are successful to the University of Cape Coast. WAEC regulations. Withheld results from WAEC can also affect your admission. So as a prospective applicant, you should desist from any form of examination malpractices before and after your WAEC examinations. Know the credibility of your school or any remedial school. There are some remedial schools, from personal experience, WAEC does not release the candidate's results on time due to alleged examination malpractice, and this can also affect your admission to the University of Cape Coast. Avoid any form of examination malpractices and also comply with all the rules and regulations that is being set by WAEC. Owing of school fees can also affect your admission to the University of Cape Coast. So try to settle all the fees you owe back in your schools before applying to the University of Cape Coast. Disciplinary problems in your school can also affect your admission. So if you know you have any disciplinary records, you must do well to sort all those issues back in your school before applying to the University of Cape Coast. The purchase of the online application voucher for the University of Cape Coast is being sold at 220 cedis cash only. And these vouchers can be purchased at the cashier's office, University of Cape Coast, the Ghana Post offices at the regional capitals, Ghana Commercial Bank, ADB Bank, GT Bank, CBG Bank, Zenith Bank, Prudential Bank, Republic Bank, ARP Bank, and ADB Bank. Application deadlines. The deadlines for the sale of application e-vouchers and the submission of completed application forms are Friday 22nd May 2020 and Friday 29th May 2020 respectively. So the deadline for the application of e-vouchers is on the Friday 22nd May 2020, and the deadline for the submission of the application forms by post is on the Friday 29th May 2020. No additional documents will be accepted after submission of the completed application forms. Applicants are to note that only photocopies of the certificate or result slip should accompany completed application forms. original certificates, result slips of applicants offered admission will be verified before registration. So when you are being offered admission, you are required to provide original certificates of your results so it can be verified, and you can also go ahead and register your program courses. Admissions list. Successful applicants will receive a text message based on the contact details they provided. If not, they should check for their status on the university website. Download your provisional admission letter by entering your serial number and your PIN number. Read carefully the instructions on your admission letter, and when you are duly satisfied, you can finally make payments of your fees at the bank. After making the payment, be checking from the university website for any new announcements regarding accommodation, orientation, registration, matriculation, as well as lectures. You may also visit the link that is admissionslist.ucc.edu.gh/online_letters/admlist.php to download your admissions letter. So we move on to the available programs being offered at the University of Cape Coast. And for the Faculty of Art under the College of Humanities and Legal Studies, there are programs like Bachelor of Arts in Arts, Bachelor of Arts in African Studies, Bachelor of Arts in Theatre Studies, Bachelor of Music, Bachelor of Arts in Film Studies, Bachelor of Arts in Dance, Bachelor of Arts in Communication Studies, and Bachelor of Arts in Chinese. Under the Faculty of Social Sciences of the College of Humanities and Legal Studies, there are programs like the Bachelor of Science, Tourism Management, Bachelor of Arts, Population and Health, Bachelor of Arts in Social Sciences, the Bachelor of Science in Hospitality Management, the Bachelor of Arts in Anthropology, and the Bachelor of Science in Geography and Regional Planning. With the School of Business under the College of Humanities and Legal Studies, there are programs like the Bachelor of Commerce, Human Resource Management, Bachelor of Commerce in Accounting, Bachelor of Commerce in Finance, Bachelor of Commerce in Procurement and Supply Chain Management, Bachelor of Commerce in Management, and a Bachelor of Commerce in Marketing. With the Faculty of Humanities and Social Sciences Education under the College of Education Studies, there are programs like Bachelor of Education Arts, Bachelor of Education Social Sciences, and this program is not for applicants with the business background electives. There's also Bachelor of Education Social Studies, Bachelor of Education in Accounting, and a Bachelor of Education in Management. With the Faculty of Science and Technology Education under the College of Education Studies, there are programs like the Bachelor of Education in Health, Physical Education and Recreation, there's Bachelor of Education in Science, Bachelor of Education in Mathematics, Bachelor of Education in Computer Science, Bachelor of Education in Health Sciences Education, Bachelor of Education in Home Economics, Bachelor of Education in Communication Design, and a Bachelor of Education in Fine Arts, Painting and Sculpture. Under the College of Education Studies, There are programs like the Bachelor of Education Early Childhood Education, Bachelor of Education Primary Education, Bachelor of Education Junior High School Education, and a Bachelor of Science in Psychology. Moving on to the College of Health and Allied Sciences, there is a program like the Bachelor of Medicine and Bachelor of Surgery. With the School of Pharmacy and Pharmaceutical Sciences, there is Doctor of Pharmacy, also known as PharmD. With the School of Nursing, there is Bachelor of Science Nursing, Bachelor of Science in Mental Health Nursing, and the Bachelor of Science Community Mental Health Nursing. With the School of Allied Health Sciences under the College of Health and Allied Sciences, there are programs like the Bachelor of Science in Biomedical Sciences, Doctor of Optometry, Bachelor of Science Medical Laboratory Technology, Bachelor of Science Clinical Nutrition and Dietetics, Bachelor of Science Physician Assistant Studies, Bachelor of Science Diagnostic Imaging Technology, Bachelor of Science Diagnostic Medical Sonography, Bachelor of Science Health Information Management, and the Bachelor of Science in Sports and Exercise Science. Moving on to the School of Agriculture under the College of Agriculture and Natural Sciences, there are programs like the Bachelor of Science in Agriculture, Bachelor of Science Agriculture Extension and Community Development, Bachelor of Science Agro-Processing, Bachelor of Science in Agribusiness, Bachelor of Science in Animal Production Post-Diploma, and the Bachelor of Science in Agricultural Extension, also a post-diploma. With the School of Biological Sciences under the College of Agriculture and Natural Sciences, there are programs like the Bachelor of Science in Molecular Biology and Biotechnology, the Bachelor of Science in Fisheries and Aquatic Sciences, Bachelor of Science in Conservation Biology and Entomology, Bachelor of Science in Biochemistry, Bachelor of Science in Environmental Science, and the Bachelor of Science in Forensic Science. With the School of Physical Sciences under the College of Agriculture and Natural Sciences, there are programs like Bachelor of Science in Laboratory Technology, Bachelor of Science in Chemistry, Bachelor of Science in Computer Science, Bachelor of Science in Water and Sanitation, Bachelor of Science in Industrial Chemistry, Bachelor of Science in Mathematics, Bachelor of Science in Statistics, and Bachelor of Science in Mathematics and Statistics. So we continue with the School of Physical Sciences, and there are other programs like the Bachelor of Science in Mathematics with Economics, Bachelor of Science in Mathematics with Business, Bachelor of Science in Actuarial Science, Bachelor of Science in Physics, Bachelor of Science in Engineering Physics, Bachelor of Science in Information Technology, and the Bachelor of Science in Meteorology and Atmospheric Physics. Admission inquiries. You are to visit the official website of the University of Cape Coast, and the website is applications.ucc.edu.gh. You can also visit the admissions unit at the administration only, and the working hours is from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. from Monday to Friday. You can also write an email to the admissions unit, and the email address is daa@ucc.edu.gh. You can also contact them by phone, and their telephone numbers are 020-811-4677, and the other number is also 033-209-2741. So I'd like to thank you viewers for watching this video. So in my next video, we are going to look at the available programs, which is going to be grouped into their colleges, the entry requirements that qualifies you for this program, and also the cutoff point for these programs. And I'm also going to make another video with regards to the University of Education Winneba. So please stay tuned by subscribing to the channel, like the videos, comment, ask questions, share to friends and relatives who are also applying this year, and also click on the notification bell. Thank you for watching, and see you in my upcoming videos.